Might this be the day where Marcos Ambrose goes from close but no cigar to that Red Auerbach moment where he savors the sweet taste of victory?
Green flag. Marcos Ambrose said, when is it going to be my turn? Well, guess what?
Might be today. Uh-oh, 29 cars out running out of fuel also.
He is out of gas. Here comes Marcus. We told you this could just be his day.
Got lots of gas. Just keep it on the pavement.
How special would this be for Marcos Ambrose?
59 car, Marcos Ambrose.
Marcos Ambrose goes to victory lane for the first time in his career at Watkins Glen.
Way to go, mate!
See, I can't believe it, man. What a night.
Woo!
Great job, guys.
We've come so close so many times, and today was our day. A lot of these guys never won. I've never won in America. It just feels so good.
And Marcos Ambrose with us live, smiling at the memory of his first NASCAR win. Congratulations again. Nationwide race at Watkins Glen, but and in terms of your background and your experience, that's where you come from. You're a road racer. But
that's right. And
you're trying to get away from that, aren't you?
Yeah, that's what a lot of people don't realize. That I've never driven on ovals until I turned up and raced a truck at Martinsville in 2006. So, you know, I really came from the wrong side of the fence, the wrong side of the tracks. And, you know, I had a lot to learn, but I'm really proud of how far I've come, and I'm desperate to get rid of that road racing specialist mantra. I want to be known as Marcos Ambrose, the NASCAR guy
NASCAR
from
racer.
Australia, and hopefully I can do that.
10th at Bristol, I mean, that's a long way from the road race circuits. You talked about it being harder than you expected. What's harder about it? I mean, you've driven big, heavy cars. The V8 Supercar series is, you know, not unlike NASCAR in some senses. What makes this so difficult?
Sure. I think the style of racing is it's easy to take for granted. You know, I mean, you're turning left all day, but, you know, you're on the ragged edge all day. The level of competition is very high. These cars are quite simple by nature, which makes them very difficult to set up because they don't want to go as fast as we push them. Mm. And so to learn to set each wheel up independently is very different from road racing also. Normally I'm a, you know, front and rear grip guy. Well, now
okay.
I've got to be individual tyres. You know, what's happened to the right front compared to the left rear, and what tyres give them up at any one point of the track. And at 200 mile an hour, that's pretty hard to learn when you've got as few brain cells as I have.
Yeah, that answers one of the questions on the chat here, which is talk about the difference technically between the two series. What would you say to the guy, guest on the chat, who says, when is Marcos going to come to his senses and drive a Commodore at Bathurst?
Well, that guy knows his stuff. Because back
tell
in Australia,
us what Bathurst is, first of all.
V8 Supercar is a category that I won a couple of championships with Ford, and there's two manufacturers. There's Ford and GM, which we call Holden, mm-hmm. Down under. And so I've been driving Ford pretty much my entire racing career in Australia, so there's a lot of bad blood down home between GM and Ford. And so Bathurst is our biggest race of the year. It's our Daytona 500. It's a long race, goes for over 6.5 hours around a 1,000-kilometre track up and down a mountain. And I've had my fair shares of bad days there and good days, but he knows his stuff, that guy. He's done his research.
Tell me about your road racing career. You won all kinds of Tasmanian karting titles. You went to England, won the Formula Ford Championship, which everybody knows is a biggie over there. In the traditional, what do they call it? I've lost it. It's the festival. In the festival, you outqualified Raikkonen and Button. They're both in Formula One today. You're not. What happened?
Sure, the list continues too. Danny Welden was my teammate over there. We had all kinds of fantastic guys. Nicholas Chiesa, another guy that did F1. Takuma Sato in F3.
Yeah.
You name it. It was an era of very special, talented drivers. And, you know, I was pleased that I went through that. It was a very difficult time. I won a fair share of races and I lost a lot too. And I had some heartbreak over there. I lost lost the Formula Ford Festival, the biggest race for junior racing probably in Europe, with a broken gear stick. Pulled the gear stick out of the car 1 year, and then the first year, Jenson Button took me out with one lap to go, and he went on to Formula One, and I went home with my tail between my legs. But
it
was really my university apprenticeship, or whatever you want to call it. It was tough, hard racing. We were fighting for sheep stations out there. It was very serious business for all of us, and we've all gone on to pretty good careers too, mind you.
Tell me about your we Americans love everything Australian. Is that mutual? Do Australians look at Americans that way? And specifically, do they know and care about NASCAR? Are you a bigger deal at home now because you're a NASCAR star?
Well, Australians think just like Americans. I mean, we are a country that was born out of England, mm-hmm. 200 and something years ago. But as you know, we have evolved into our own country. We rely on America to save us in case we get in trouble as far as the Navy's concerned. I think we've got a We've got one of the biggest land masses, or we are totally seabound as a country, and we've got about 7 boats, I think, to save us. So we need you guys
we'll
to come and help
you.
Us out if we get ourselves in trouble. And as far as the TV and culture and everything, we are very much American-based. And so for me to come to America and race, it was really just like racing in another state of Australia. I've been welcomed in the US too, mind you, by my neighbours, my friends, that I've made here, by the NASCAR officials, by the drivers and teams and fans. It really has been an awesome experience. And it was something that, you know, I didn't expect. You know, I thought I was going to have a tough time trying to break in, but I guess the Aussie accent helps out, and Crocodile Dundee and Steve Irwin have really helped too.
Well, you're just a good guy too. Add Wind Tunnel to that list of people who welcome you. We're glad to have you here. We appreciate your time tonight.